Why do people always talk about keeping global average atmospheric temperatures from rising 2 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels? Is there some awful, horrible thing that happens when global temperatures get bumped that precise amount? Do we all begin to melt? Do the ice caps finally give way and the oceans turn into a puddle of acid? Well, no. It's super arbitrary. And in a lot of ways, counterproductive. Climate change is happening now. It isn't something that's slowly approaching and is gonna acid rain down on us when we finally get bumped that 2 degrees Celsius. In fact, global average temperatures have already risen 0.8 degrees Celsius, but that's just an average. In the polls, it's happening much more rapidly. And 93% of the Great Barrier Reef showed some signs of bleaching this year, a direct result of climate change. 2016 is already the hottest year on record, and it isn't even July yet. So where did this 2 degrees Celsius benchmark come from? An economist, actually, William Nordhaus. His paper in 1975 said, if there were global temperatures more than 2 or 3 degrees Celsius above the current average temperature, this would take the climate outside of the range of observations which have been made over the last several hundred thousand years. And Nordhaus, for an economist, wasn't that far off. While he was basing his thoughts on preliminary investigations, studies have since shown that temperatures very rarely went outside of that 2 degrees Celsius increase mark in over 100,000 years. But even Nordhaus doesn't recommend 2 degrees Celsius as some kind of guardrail or benchmark. It serves as an example in his paper, a warning. In fact, he looks to concentrations of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere as a way better measure of how much people are messing up the planet. But I'm gonna have to circle back to that. In 1990, the Stockholm Environmental Institute released a report suggesting several ways to measure climate change. Sea level rise, carbon dioxide, and global warming. They suggested this 2 degrees Celsius limit. Fast forward to 2009, and this 2 degrees thing has started to stick. Kinda. During the failed Copenhagen climate talks, the public and media demanded binding climate regulation, frequently using that 2 degrees Celsius thing as some kind of guardrail. The next year, 2 degrees Celsius made it into global policy in the Cancun agreements. And in the most recent Paris climate talks, 2 degrees Celsius is front and center. If you heard anything about the talks, it was probably that many countries signed on to prevent this 2 degrees Celsius rise. Now, 2 degrees Celsius has its benefits. It gives us something to avoid, a rallying call, a number to put down in official documents. But many argue that it gives countries and global actions like the Paris climate talks a number to hide behind. Plus, 2 degrees Celsius doesn't sound like a lot. It's hard to conceptualize because to me, a 2 degrees Celsius rise doesn't feel like a lot. And yes, I know it's global averages, but if you just hear it in passing, it doesn't sound that dramatic. And something super important to remember is that a 2 degrees Celsius rise is not a safe limit. Many scientists say it's way too far, and we're almost certainly gonna hit it. All the estimates that cut emissions enough before we hit that dreaded number are heroic attempts that, if past actions are any example, won't see the light of day. But the biggest problem with the 2 degrees Celsius limit is it lets a lot of other climate markers pass by without notice. Compared to many other markers, the average temperature hasn't risen that much in the last 20 years. It simply isn't a great signifier of what's happening. We need to look at other markers like ocean heat anomalies and acidification, or perhaps most effectively, the concentration of carbon in the atmosphere. I've talked about one of my favorite organizations, 350.org, before, but it bears repeating that measuring and attempting to reduce the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is perhaps the most effective way to combat climate change. It still gives a simple, easy number to remember if you don't have the time to get into the intricacies of the newest climate model. Having a goal is important to any movement, and 350 is as great a goal as any. Especially considering right now, atmospheric carbon is hovering at about 407. While doing research for this video, I found a lot of quotes from scientists that are particularly apt to the topic. One climate scientist, Gavin Schmidt, said of arguing over the validity of a 2 degrees Celsius marker, if you were driving in completely the wrong direction, arguing about where you'll park if you arrive isn't your highest priority. Emissions have got to get to zero if we want any hope of mitigating climate change, so whether it's 350 or 2 degrees Celsius or something else entirely that we deem too far, zero is what we really want. Zero emissions.